have to confess that this is my first time being here and so speaking about human rights during elections. I will do this in a more general way, not to be country specific, but I'm here also in the later discussion to learn more from you. Of course, I heard a lot yesterday during some meetings with governmental officials and others. I see the chief of the Human Rights Commission yesterday. Happy to meet you again, and I'm happy that we have a cooperation partner here for the workshop that shows that the changes in Ethiopia are used to promote human rights, and that is in the focus of the work. This is done by the Konrad Adenauer Foundation in a lot of in many countries around the world. In particular, I will refrain from stepping onto the slippery ice of ethnic divisions that obviously marks the political process in Ethiopia. I'm very aware and heard a lot of those divisions and the inherent risk. Please keep that in mind in my following remarks. However, I've been, as the ambassador kindly referred to, a spokesperson on human rights in my parliamentary works for 7 years, and the main principles on human rights are so fundamental that they always apply. From Hong Kong to Beirut to Santiago de Chile, people are currently demonstrating against actions of their governments, and a free press is reporting about it all over the world. The local governments might see this as a threat. I welcome it as a free expression of the opinion of demonstrators. They are exercising their human rights to their own opinion and to express this opinion in a peaceful demonstration. These rights are enshrined in Article 19 and 20 in the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. On December 10th, we are celebrating the 71st anniversary of its proclamation in Paris in 1948. At the time, it was the result of the Second World War and the Holocaust, the worst war crime and human rights violation in the history of mankind perpetrated by Nazi Germany. The Universal Declaration on Human Rights was a landmark decision. It was an answer to war by putting the unalienable rights of the individual human being at the center of attention. While in numerous places human rights violation continues, the international community now had a reference point on which to base appeals to those violations to stop. And in many cases, this was successful. Ethiopia is one of the original signatories of the Universal Declaration on Human Rights. It was, together with Egypt and Liberia, one of three African countries to sign it. I believe many serious conflicts could be avoided if governments were more relaxed when hearing dissent from their population, from civil society and from opposition parties. They should recognize it as a part of a joint effort to improve the well-being of all. Visionary leaders in Ethiopia have embarked on this transformative process in the past 2 years. And that is why the world is now closely watching the events in Ethiopia, and why it was mentioned before, so many politicians from my country like to visit Ethiopia these days. Prime Minister Dr. Abiy Ahmed, who will receive the Nobel Peace Prize in a few days, has accelerated the reforms started by his predecessor, Haile Mariam Desalegn, in an exemplary way. He has released political prisoners, decriminalized the opposition and the press, and he has begun a dialogue with groups previously forbidden. For there to be a success, it is crucial that this is an undertaking, always undertaken without violence. The Prime Minister has brought women into various leading positions in politics, from the presidency to the Supreme Court and the Electoral Commission and in his cabinet. This will certainly benefit Ethiopian society. Many so-called advanced countries are actually lagging behind. And I can tell you that in my own party there is an ongoing debate about setting minimum quota for women in certain high-ranking positions. So the fight is all over the world, and there are a lot of good examples given by your Prime Minister. The Prime Minister has also made a peace agreement with Eritrea. That was a bold act, and I hope it will pay off with some tangible peace dividend. Unfortunately, Eritrea's undemocratic leadership is internally not yet following the positive example set here in Addis Abeba. Article 21 of the Human Rights Declaration stipulates everyone's right to free and fair elections. Unfortunately, this right is being withheld from people in many countries, and in many countries in Africa in particular. I hope that the Ethiopia will instead set a positive example for others to follow. The elections scheduled for May 2020 will be an important test for the reforms and for the democratic change. A lot will depend on whether the current opposition and perhaps also international observers judge them to be free and fair. Fair elections include the fulfillment of human rights during the electoral process. Eligibility to vote and also to run as a candidate for office has to conform with international laws. It should not be restricted. In many countries, for example in Russia, the government very quickly finds some reasons to exclude opposition candidates from running when they appear to have a good chance to getting too many votes. All democratic parties need to be able to be part of this process. They and all candidates also need to be able to run an open and public campaign without being intimidated. Civil society and other political parties and the press have to be allowed to report completely and openly about the campaign of all the parties, the candidates and their program. In election day, voters need to be able to exercise their right to vote freely, and the continuing process needs to be, and the counting process needs to be transparent and reliable. When all this has been judged to be the case, the losers of the election need to accept the result. The losers' democratic responsibility is then to begin work as a constructive parliamentary opposition. A prominent German social democrat once said, "Opposition is rubbish." Franz Mitterrand for all Germans. I can confirm this, having experiences my own. But it is a necessary part of a long-term sustainable democracy. I myself was part of the opposition from 1998 to 2005, when Germany was governed by a social democratic and green party coalition under Chancellor Gerhard Schröder. It was actually exactly my time as a spokesperson on human rights in our parliamentary group. In any case, the situation has happened in Kenya in 2007 should be avoided at all costs when the election ended in chaos and led to unrest with more than 1,500 dead. Let me cite another historic example. In Germany, we have just had celebrated the fall of the Berlin Wall 30 years ago. Of course, there were many factors that contributed to it, including Michael Gorbachev's policy of glasnost and perestroika. But the final push of the popular uprising that led to the fall of the Berlin Wall 6 months later began with the local elections in East Germany in May 89. The election result was bluntly forged. The Communist Party, according to the official results, got 98.85% of the vote, which everyone knew could not be true. This led to the beginning of unrest and demonstration that then increased over the summer. In addition to the integrity of the political process and the election itself, success of any democratic government, of course, depends on social, economic, and inclusive development progress for the majority of the population, the large proportion of young people, and the huge intake of refugees by Ethiopia don't make this task any easier. Development progress depends on strong and resilient democratic institutions that can withstand a change in government. This is difficult to achieve overnight and will take time. It is also a core task of development cooperation to support counties in countries in institution building. And the Konrad Adenauer Foundation is a part of that cooperation. This brings me finally to a piece of good news that some of you may already heard. Konrad Adenauer Foundation aims to have a permanent base in Addis Ababa by opening an office as soon as possible. There are some procedural measures to be undertaken. Our aim is twofold. We want to follow the remarkable political events in Ethiopia directly and more closely by organizing dialogue events like the one today, holding seminars, and by facilitating contact between government and non-government policymakers from Ethiopia and Germany. For the Konrad Adenauer Foundation, as well as for the Christian Democratic Party in Germany, to which the KAS is affiliated, the fight for human rights is one of the main pillars of their work around the world and in Germany, of course, as well. Human rights will be therefore also be a major topic. It is planned in the planned work here in Ethiopia. But there is a second good reason to have an office in Addis Ababa. While the seat of the African Union, Addis Ababa is a city of multilateral institutions. One could call the Brussels of Africa. I don't know whether every British people would like that nickname, Brussels of Africa. In Germany, most of us would. Okay. While multilateralism is under attack globally, from populist government and groups, from the United States to Brazil and the Philippines, our foundation is making a point of opening offices in hotspots of multilateralism like New York, Geneva or Vienna, and hopefully soon in Addis Ababa. The goal is to support multilateral institutions with similar instruments as outlined for Ethiopia. On a second level, the Konrad Adenauer Foundation is also building awareness about the importance of international cooperation back home by publication and events in Germany. Disputes and setbacks on specific issues, notwithstanding, we have many of them in the European Union as well. I see the African Union as a very positive signal that Africa is coming together on many issues. I welcome the fact that African countries have agreed and announced themselves to the Agenda 2063, the Africa we want. This certainly increases African ownership and has made a continental strategy completing the UN Sustainable Development Goals. I also welcome the fact that the adherence to human rights and democratic values are an important part of that Agenda 23 and so part 63 and so part also of the cooperation of African Union with Europe. What I object to the 63 part first of all as either original signatories of the when I object to this by 63 part, first of all, either original signatories to the Declaration of Human Rights in 48 like Ethiopia or later as they became members of the United Nations, all countries are obliged to immediate and complete adherence to human rights principles. In addition, in doing so, progress of all other goals of the Agenda 2063 by most historical experience will be faster and more sustainable. A second positive signal that the African Union sent in recent years is the Continental Free Trade Agreement. This does not only benefit African people by liberation intra-regional trade, it will also facilitate development-friendly trade agreements with the EU or other blocs. Finally, I will mention regional peacekeeping operation being undertaken under the auspices of the AU and a regional approach to health issues, for example, through the AU's Center for Disease Control. On these issues and more, Konrad Adenauer Foundation wants to partner with the EU and will find to cooperate in a mutual beneficial way. So in the end, I would like to wish Arne Wolf all the best for the office starting here in Addis Abeba, and having met the one who will soon head the office of Friedrich Ebert Foundation, I would like to wish you all the best for your work also. A little remark for the Germans. If the Social Democrats and the Christian Democrats in government would cooperate as well as the political foundation are doing, especially abroad, the Germans would like the government even more than they do now. So I think we could learn from the good cooperation you are doing in a lot of places in the world, and to show that there is really a will soon to be here within our own base. Dear Arne, I would like to hand over this sign for our new office, so that at least everyone knows it's a serious idea. We will be here, and we hope very soon. Thank you.